Hello friends, welcome to Online Study for You. This is Pratik Srivastava here. And friends, in today's session, I am going to discuss the crypt arithmetic problem which was asked previously in the Infosys exam. So friends, this question has to be done with patience and we will be definitely able to do. So friends, before solving this question, I will just suggest you to watch the previous video on crypt arithmetic where I have discussed the rule and the basics. And then friends, this question you will be easily able to understand and do by yourself. So friends, before solving the question, we had discussed few rules in the previous video. So friends, all the alphabets has to be denoted or represented by the values from 0 to 9, and each alphabet's representation will be with unique digits. And second one, what I told friends, so if you are adding two digits, so the maximum digit will be 9, and friends, each digit has to be unique. So 9 plus 8 will be 17. So friends, the maximum carryover you will be getting as 1. The maximum carryover you will be getting as 1. And friends, using these rules, we will try to solve this problem. And if any rule else is required, I will be telling you in the problem itself. So friends, send plus more. is nothing but money, and this is what you have to add and get the values of money from here, friends, right? Okay, now friends, what will be the value of M? So what will be the value of M? So friends, here I will write SENDMORY. So whatever the value of money we will be getting, or the send MORY, we will be writing it here. So friends, what will be the value of M? So friends, so anybody can answer it here. The value of M will be 1. Now, how the value of M will be 1? Because friends, M will be nothing but the carryover of the addition of S plus M. So S plus M, when you will add, and whatever the carryover will be there, that will be nothing but the value of M. And friends, we can say from here, S and M addition will be definitely more than 10. That is the only reason there will be a carryover. So here 1 will be carry forwarded. So friends, the maximum value which can be carry forwarded is 1, because 0 to 9, so the maximum digit I can take 9 and 8, because both the digit cannot be same. So 9 plus 8 will be 17. So the maximum carryover can be 1. So the value of M, we can easily get it as 1, friends, right? Okay, so the same thing, friends, now I can write it like this. So SEND, and here it will be M. So the value of M is nothing but 1 now, and O, and here R, and here E, and this will be nothing but, friends, 1, because the value of M is nothing but now 1, right? Okay, now we will try to calculate the value of O and S. Okay, now friends, so try to understand here. So friends, S plus 1, the addition of S plus 1 has to be either 10 or greater than 10. Then only it will give a carry forward. Okay. Now friends, so S value is 9. Then 9 plus 1 will be what, friends? 9 plus 1 will be nothing but 10. So it can give a carry forward. So you can say, sir, 9, S value can be 9. And M value is 1, and there may be a possibility that you will be getting one carry forward from the second column here, right? So first column, second column, yes, that is also possible. So friends, in that case, 9 plus 2 will be 11, so the value of O will be 1. But friends, we already know two alphabets cannot have the same value. In the rules we have discussed, two alphabets cannot have the same value. So friends, this will not occur here. Okay, see, we know that one has to be carry forwarded. So friends, that is the reason we are taking S is equals to 9. Now friends, we may have one more case when S is equals to 8 and plus 1, and 1 will be carry forwarded from here. So 1 plus 8 plus 2, this will also give us 10. So friends, the basic thing is we have to get a carry forward, and that only will be the value of M. So friends, I can say the value of S can be 8 or 9. 8 or 9. So if there is no carry forward, if there is no carry forward, then the value of S has to be 9, then only 9 plus 1 will be equal to 10 and it will give a carry forward as 1. If there is a carry forward, in that case the value of S will be 8 and 8 plus 2 will be nothing but, that means this is plus M will be nothing but 10. So that carry forward will be M and that will be nothing but the value of M here, friends. Okay, so friends, 9 plus 2, so 1 carry forward and the S value of is 9 plus 1 cannot be the case because here 9 plus 2 will be 11 but already the value of M is 1. So this case is eliminated. So what will be the value of, so what will be the value of O, friends? So the value of O will be nothing but 0. So the value of O will be nothing but 0. Then only, friends, we will be getting 1 as a carry forward. It cannot be 1, friends. So this will be nothing but 0 now. Okay, now friends, let's move to the third column. So still we have not got the value for S, so let's move to the third column. Okay, so friends, third column, let me write it again. So S E N D, and this is 1 and this is nothing but, friends, this will be nothing but 0 and R and E, because O is nothing but 0 now, and again here it was M, so M is 1 and this is nothing but, friends, 0 and this is N E Y. Now friends, you see E plus 0 is equals to N. So E plus 0 is equals to N. So friends, this will not be true. This will not be true. Why, friends, you can ask me, I will tell you the reason. Because friends, two alphabets value cannot be same. So E cannot be equal to N because this is now 0. This is now what? 0. So E plus 0 will become equal to N. So E will become equal to N. So friends, no two alphabets can have the, friends, rule says no two alphabets can have the same digit. So it has to be different. So friends, now how to make it different? How it will be different? So friends, it is very easy. So 1 will be definitely carry forwarding here. So 1 plus E will be equal to N. 1 plus E will be equal to N. In that case only, friends, E will be not equal to N. Otherwise, if there is no carry forward, if there is no carry over, if there is no carry over, friends, then, friends, it is very simple. E will become equal to N and these two alphabets will have the same digit, which is completely wrong according to the crypt arithmetic rules, friend. So 1 plus E will be equal to N, friend. So this is what we can say from here. Now, friends, One more thing we can say. So the value of E, will be definitely less than 9. Sir, how can we say the value of E will be definitely less than 9? Can you tell me? So friends, the value of E, if E value will be 9, then E value is 9 and 1 carry over. So 9 plus 1 will be equal to 10. So N value will become equal to 0, but we already know O value is equals to 0. So N at any cost, the value of N cannot be equal to 0. So friends, it is very much clear the E value will be less than 9. Okay, friends. So now if E value is less than 9, then definitely 9, see, E value will be less than 9. So suppose if it is 8, 8 plus 0 will be 8. That means there will be no carry forward from here. That means there will be no carry forward from, there will be no carry forward from the second column. So it is very much clear, friends. The reason is the E value cannot be greater than 9 or equal to 9. So if E value is less than 9, then less than 9 means 8 plus 0. 8 plus 0 will be 8. It will not produce any carry forward. So friends, we were confused. We were not able to decide that S value will be 8 or 9. So S value will be 8 only in the case of carry forward. But actually, there is no carry forward. So the value of S will become 9. So the value of S will become 9. So now friends, this is also clear for you. Now friends, moving towards the third column. So friends, actually we should always try to attempt from the left side. So friends, we know from here. So I can say this is one equation. So 1 plus E will be equal to 9. So this, friends, we already know this is one of the equation. Suppose equation 1, this we have got it from the here, which we had already written here, right? Okay. Now friends, N plus R is equals to E. So friends, you can see n plus r is going to, n plus r is going to give a carry forward. So friends, I can write from here, right? See, we already know n plus r is going to give a carry forward, which we have already concluded here. Now friends, n plus r is going to give a carry forward, so it will be nothing but 10 plus e. So friends, suppose if n is 10 and r is 5, so it will give nothing but 15. So I can write 10 plus 5, so same thing I have written here, okay? But friends, one more thing we do not know, if column 1 will be giving a carry forward or not, that still has to be decided. So friends, I will take two possibilities here. So the first case we have taken with no carry forward, okay? So friends, if there is no carry forward, then n plus r will be equal to 10 plus e, because n plus r is going to give a carry over, okay? A carry forward, n plus r will be going to give a value which will have a carry forward, okay? Now friends, d plus e can also give a carry forward to 1. So in that case friends, see, the maximum carry forward will be always 1. So that is the reason blindly I am taking plus 1. So now friends, plus 1 plus n plus r will be equal to 10 plus, will be equal to 10 plus e. That is in case of carry forward, when there is a carry over. Okay, so when there is a carry over, friends. Now, so both the possibilities, friends, we will take and we will see what we are getting. So friends, first one, n plus r. So let me write here. So n plus r. So friends, there is one equation is there. So you can see n will be nothing but equal to e plus 1. So n will be nothing but e plus 1. And so n will be equal to e plus 1. And plus, friends, r is equals to 10 plus e. Now friends, e and e cancel. So r will be equal to 10 minus 1, which is 9. So the value of r is 9. But friends, already we know the value of s is equals to 9. So it is very much clear that first possibility, whatever you have assumed, is wrong. So second one we'll have to consider here, friends. So 1 plus n will be nothing but 1 plus e is equals to 10 plus e is equal, sorry, r, we have missed it, plus r. So 1 plus n is nothing but 1 plus e, and plus r is equals to 10 plus e. Now friends, e and e cancel, r will be equal to 10 minus 2. So the value of r will be nothing but 8. So the value of r will be nothing but 8, friends. So friends, the second possibility, whatever we have taken from there, we have got the value of r is equals to 8. So friends, slowly, slowly we are able to do the values, friends. Now, okay. Now friends, let's see. Now we know here, friends, d plus e is going to be added. So let me get some space here, friends. Okay. So now friends, you see d plus e. So now d plus e will give a carry over, will give a value where carry over or carry forward will be there. Okay, friends. So friends, d plus e value should be greater than 12. Equal to or greater than 12. Sir, why? Because if d plus e value is 10, or if d plus e the value is 11, then the unit digit will be 0. But we already know O is 0. If d plus e is 11, then the unit digit will be 1. But we already know m is equals to 1. So friends, d plus e value has to be greater than 12. Then only the unit digit will be 2 and 1 will be carry forwarded. Right? Okay. Now friends, from here I can say d and e value cannot be equal to 8 or 9. So why it cannot be equal to 8 or 9? Because 8 is r and s is 9. So d and e value cannot be equal to 8 or 9. So friends, d or e value can be 7, 5 and 7, 6. 7, 5 or 7, 6. So out of these two, one will be true, because it should be more than and equal to 12. So friends, 8 and 9 value not possible, because it is already assigned to r and s. So the value which is possible is 7,5 or 7,6. So either it can be 12. So 7 plus 5 will be 12, and 7 plus 6 will be nothing but 13. So these two value is only possible. Now friends, out of these two friends, we have to find it out which value will be true here, right? Okay. Now friends, let's assume the value of E is equals to 7, okay? And D, so if the value of E is equals to 7, then 5 or 6 will be the value of nothing but D. But when we assume the value of E is equals to 7, then E is 7 and 7 plus 1 and 7 plus 1 will become 8. And 8 is the value of n, which will become wrong, friends, because we already know the value of r is 8. So friends, the value of e is equals to 7 is not possible. Okay, so friends, d or e has to be 7. So friends, it is very much clear from here the value of d will be equal to 7, because if the value of e is equals to 7, then 7 plus 1 will be 8 and the value of n will become 8, but they're clearly telling the value of r is equals to 8, so e cannot be 7. Now d will be 7 and e will be either 5 or e will be either 5 or 6. Okay, now friends, here we have to eliminate one of the values of e. Okay friends, so let's see how can we do that. Okay, so friends, if e value will be 6 here, then 6 plus 1 will be 7. So again the value of n will become 7, but we already know the value of d is 7. So even e value 6 is also not possible, because when we are putting, see friends, e plus 1 plus e plus 0 is equals to n. So when the value of e is equals to 6, then 6 plus 1 will be 7, the value of n will become 7, but we already know d we have finalized as 7, so e 6 is also not possible, the value of e can be only 5. So friends, e value will be 5 and d value is nothing but 7. So when e value will be 5, then 5 plus 1 will become 6, then the value of n will become 6, e is 5, 5 plus 1 is nothing but 6. And what about y, friends? So because d we have considered as 7 and e we have considered as 5, so 7 plus 5 will be 12, so y value will be nothing but 2, friends. So friends, easily we are able to get the values of these things. The only thing is, friends, I am teaching you here, so it is taking little more time, but once you solve the problem, it will be easy for you to understand and you can solve any kind of problem. Now friends, you have to get the sum of money. So friends, you can see M is nothing but 1, O is nothing but 0, N is nothing but, friends, 6, E is nothing but, friends, 5, and Y is nothing but, friends, 2. So 5 plus 2 is 7, 7 plus 6 is 13, and 13 plus 1 is 14. So friends, 14 will be the answer for this question. And friends, crypt arithmetic is a very good problem, or is a very, you know, the logical kind of problem which will be asked in Infosys and eLitmus exam. So friends, thanks a lot for watching the video. If you really like the video or loved the video, then friends, please hit a like, comment below and share with your friends so that they will be also getting benefited. Thanks a lot, friends, for watching the video.